only concern is about prolonged febrile seizures. So brief seizures really do not require treatment. Prolonged febrile seizures, you have to follow the status protocol. So must remember that febrile seizures, simple ones, are generally benign. Only concern is about prolonged febrile seizures. So brief seizures really do not require treatment. Prolonged febrile seizures, you have to follow the status protocol. So treatment of acute attack, simple febrile seizures, most febrile seizures would have subsided by the time they reach a doctor. If the child has returned to a normal baseline, is active and playful, then you don't need to give benzodiazepines or anything else. Of course, if the child has fever, give antipyretics. However, if the child is seizing, then you have to treat as any other acute seizure by maintaining airway, ABC, giving benzodiazepines and putting an IV line, or if that is not available, giving intranasal or buccal midazolam. Home care. This is very important because more than 90% of febrile seizures are self-limited, and therefore the child is safe at home. And you can counsel and empower the parents, ask them to put the child in a position so that you prevent aspiration. So generally we say, you know, in a left lateral position so that the saliva, etc., drools out. Clear the airway, have no tight clothing, avoid panic, and tell them about potentially harmful practices. Not to try to give water or to resuscitate the child or to forcefully open the mouth of the child with a spoon, etc. Avoid that and let the seizure get over. However, if the seizure does not get over within a minute or two, and although they say more than 5 minutes, I would generally say within a minute or two, because getting the midazolam nasal spray and spraying also takes another couple of minutes. So you can give nasal midazolam or rectal diazepam. These days, nasal midazolam is preferred because of the ease of administration. So this generally comes as a pamphlet, and actually when you advise, you should tell the parents, practice once even when there's no need, so that they know if there is a need, how to give it. How about, you know, intermittent prophylaxis? Intermittent prophylaxis can be given in children with febrile seizures when you suspect that they are likely to have recurrences. Also, continuous prophylaxis with sodium valproate and phenobarb can be given in extremely rare circumstances. We'll talk about that. But do remember that phenytoin, carbamazepine, vigabatrin, gabapentin, etc. are not effective, neither in intermittent nor in continuous prophylaxis. So do not give these medications. The intermittent prophylaxis benzodiazepines, you could use nitrazepam, diazepam, midazolam or clobazam. So generally these days people have switched to clobazam or of course continued with diazepam. So at the onset of fever, you start and you give for about 48 to 72 hours. Whatever you use, the ground rules are that the drugs must cross the blood-brain barrier, should be safe, give the optimal dose, and you have to give minimum for 48 to 72 hours. Start early. That's the important thing. Sometimes, you know, people wait for the fever to rise and then they will start. But before that, the febrile seizure will occur. So therefore, you should give as soon as the parents feel that the child is sick and is getting a fever, immediately the intermittent prophylaxis should be started. So timely compliance in fever is the key to success. So this study, which was done with placebo versus oral diazepam, they found that there was a modest reduction and of seizures, recurrences, if you used oral diazepam. Other drug of course used is, as I said, clobazam. We generally can give 1 mg per kg as a single daily dose or divided, and this is again found to be useful. So the drugs for continuous prophylaxis include sodium valproate and phenobarb and clobazam, but not the carbamazepine, phenytoin. Of course, newer drugs have not been tried, but certainly they have their own side effects and therefore should not be used unless mandatory.